Hi guys, welcome to Anatomy of an Artwork. Just to let you know, I'm voiceovering this in my kitchen because at the moment there's a coronavirus pandemic and everyone's working from home. So if you hear any weird sounds in the background and it sounds a bit tinny, I apologize in advance.
I have a favor to ask you guys. If you love Fieldey TV and want to see more great content before everybody else directly in your inbox, please sign up to my new Mad Skills Master Club. So this is going to be a weekly-ish digest. You're going to get to see all the videos and tutorials before everybody else on YouTube. There's going to be special offers and heaps of awesome exclusive content. Please click on the link to sign up today.
So the project is the first job that I did after having a baby. So I'd had roughly 4 months off before doing this. And to say I was a little bit nervous about painting again is a bit of an understatement, but it was a really cool project that I did for Shot Darts in New Zealand. So Gavin contacted me and they were going to have an exhibition of painted dartboard cabinet doors in New Zealand. So he sent me the dartboard doors, which were just like a white painted piece of wood, two of them, and I created some concepts to show him. So my first concept was going to be from The Shining, because I thought that would be pretty funny to have the dartboard doors open, but it didn't really gel with Gavin, which is totally fair enough. So I came up with another idea of something I really wanted to paint, which was this zombie pinup girl. So the first step was to paint a background color all over the doors. So I had three blues that I was thinking about using, but I wanted to match it to a darker shade of spray paint that I already had in my studio. So I walked very quickly through a very messy house and matched them against the colors that I already had until I found one that I thought would be a good fit. So because these doors are kind of semi-industrial, they're an artwork, but they're gonna be used to house a dart cabinet. I decided to use a house paint for the background so it'd be quite durable. So I'm just putting on two coats of a normal Dulux house paint for the background. So I waited for them to dry, and when that was totally dry, I grabbed my spray paint that I'd selected and I wanted to create a kind of a dark feathering around the outside of the artwork to draw attention to the figure in the middle. So after shaking the can really, really well, I used a sort of a feathering technique, so holding the can on the side to get really nice soft edges. So after leaving it outside overnight to off gas, I brought it back into my studio, and to get the concept onto the artwork for me to start painting, I'm just using a normal pencil, and there's normally a whole bunch of different ways I do this. Sometimes I use a projector, sometimes I grid it if I want to be really precise. In this case, she's a zombie. You can kind of get away with some kind of anatomical errors, so I'm just freestyling it up on the board right now. So in the background you can't see, but I'm looking at my computer, which has the reference material on it. I sometimes find that freestyling it can give the best result. Like, yes, sometimes you can end up with a whole bunch of inaccuracies, but I think you get sort of a wilder and freer end result than if you grid it or use a projector. So with the outlines all ready, my next step is to get in there and just quick and dirty get some paint on that canvas. So I'm just using one flat color to kind of give myself some shape so I can tell at this stage whether things need adjusting or whether the proportions are right. And anyway, you can see me painting white, that's because I want to create a background, like a white finish, so that when I put the color on over top, it'll be nice and bright. This is still the underpainting stage, but I've added in a few sort of shadows and a few highlights because I'm trying to feel my way through this and sort of sort out the planes on her face. So try to figure out which parts of her face are coming forward and which parts are going to be in shadow, particularly because she's a zombie and I don't have any actual reference that I'm painting from. I'm painting from a picture of a girl, and I'm also using some screenshots from a Walking Dead episode to kind of replicate that really gross zombie skin. And if you want to learn a bit more about how I do that, there's a related tutorial up in the corner. The other thing I'm doing now is I'm sort of trying to figure out where I'm going to put these kind of gross weepy sores on her face. So I'm starting to just kind of add those in, and I can go back over the top with the green to kind of push some of them back or change the shapes of them. This whole process sort of took part over about, I think, 2 or 3 days of 45 minute baby nap times. And I was getting a bit stressed out because, you know, this is called the ugly stage for a reason, in that it is really ugly, but it felt like it was taking forever for me to get through it. Normally I would just smash out the ugly stage in a matter of hours, but at this stage I only had a few hours to work in a day. So I was starting to wonder if I'd kind of lost my touch, as it was, or if I'd forgotten how to paint. But I had to, at this point, just knuckle down and try and remain calm and just push through it. So I also call this the fear, that feeling when you're a bit worried about an artwork and it's the direction that it's going in. So if you want to find out a bit more about that, I also have a little vlog about that. So check out the related clip in the corner. So as I mentioned, after feeling a bit worried or a bit despondent because I didn't feel like it was coming together very well or very quickly, I sat down the next morning and decided to do the eyes, because sometimes I find that if you get the eyes right and as a focal point, then the rest of the artwork will start to come together smoothly, and then you'll start to build up confidence about the rest of the painting. And so much of the time, painting is a confidence game, or, you know, pretty much any art making, I reckon, is a confidence game. So when I got those eyes in, and I got that particularly creepy, like, head injury look with one pupil bigger than the other, that was when I started to see the path forward with this artwork, and I was like, oh, phew, thank God, I can still paint. So that's a shout out for all you guys out there, is that, and a confession, is that even seasoned artists or people who've been painting for a long time still have moments of crisis and fear about their own ability or about the path an artwork's taking. So it's hard sometimes. So you can see it really starting to come together, and I'm just doing a process of building up the layers here. So I talk about this a lot in my tutorials. I start with the ugly stage, which you saw, and you can see, particularly around the eyes, where it's really coming together, and I dry off the artwork and then paint the next layer in over top. And so each subsequent layer is a lot more refined with a lot more detail. So it starts off crude and then looks really awesome. Adding in the really dark shades, like the black eyeliner on her eyes, is really making it start to pop and look as I imagined it looking. So while I've still got those blacks on my palette, which is actually a mix of brown and blue and with a tiny amount of black, I'm gonna go up and, up to the top of the artwork and paint in her hair at the same time. Zombie girl's face is starting to look really nice now. I'm very happy with that. So what I'm starting to do now is start to bring some form to her face. So I'm using some highlight contouring on her face to start to bring some areas forward with the highlights, and shadows to, define her nose a bit more and things like that. Now that the background of her face is done, if you know what I mean, it's time to start adding in the gross holes in her skin over the top of that. So that's what I'm doing now. I'm just starting with shadows, starting with a mid-tone, then adding shadows and highlights to start to get as realistic as I can looking zombie skin holes. This kind of stuff takes a really long time because it's quite fiddly, but I really love it. It's so much fun to paint. Generally, I work in a top to bottom kind of fashion. So, you know, I'm happy enough with the stuff going on at the top of her head, so I'm moving my way down and building up the rest of it. But as I go, you'll see me skipping, you know, go back to her eyes and paint something in there or add highlights. That's either because I've noticed things that need correcting or could do with highlighting, or it's because I have a similar color mixed on my palette and realize that I should use that in another part of the artwork. But it's really cool because you can kind of see it all coming together. So I'm concentrating on the mouth and that kind of under cheek area and getting that sort of looking good before moving on to the next thing. So next thing is actually the bandana around her head. And I have a bit of a cheeky cheat for doing patterns and things, which is that I just paint it on. Like, so I'm painting the leopard print on here with absolutely no regard to shading or highlights. I just try and make it look like it might be folding a little bit around the headscarf. And then what I do is I dry all the paint, make sure it's really dry, and then mix a shadow color and apply that over top using either some water or some glazing medium to add all the shadows in and make it look, you know, like a pattern on a scarf that's on someone's head. And then after that's dry, I add some highlights in as well. Now that I'm more or less happy with the top half of her face, it's time to tackle the rest of her body. So same process as before, pretty much. I'm just adding in shadows and highlights and building up the form. And then I start adding in, you know, like the little zombie details. And I tackle the heart that she's holding. I love painting hearts and organs and things like this. So I had so much fun painting this. I don't know what it is about them, but I think it might be all the little folds and like creepy glistening highlights and things like that. But I don't know, I always really enjoy painting something which is kind of gross and making it look a little bit beautiful. So when I got this heart painted in, I was super stoked. I think it's actually probably my favorite piece of the whole artwork. I gotta say, look, this is probably a little bit too much heart footage. It's probably a little too self-indulgent, but I gotta say, I'm leaving it in because I'm really enjoying it, watching it being painted again. So after I'm happy with my heart and my little eye flower and stuff like that, it's time to start adding in the final touches and the background. So I'm starting with a double outline. So I'm doing a pale blue outline around her, which is actually on the outside of the black outline that I'm going to put on later. But because it's lighter than black, I do that first and the black goes over the top of that. For this piece, I don't think I initially had an idea of what I wanted to do with the background. And I thought it was looking a bit bland, so I got the idea of painting kind of a tattoo style, or just a normal style, I guess, spider web in the background to kind of draw attention to her and, you know, make it look a little bit cool. So when all that pale blue paint is dry and it's safe to go back in the water, that's when I bust out my final favorite step, and that is doing the outlining. So I talk a lot about outlining, and again, I'm going to put a related tutorial up in the corner so you can click on that and watch the full video about how I do it. But I love to use like a nice soft sable brush to get some really lovely flicks on the end of the tails of the outlines, and also to get a nice range of thick and thin strokes. So that's the final artwork done, so I do need to clear coat it before I send it off to its new home. But I am so stoked with this one. It was such a relief to get my first artwork done after having a baby. So I was super sleep deprived when I was painting this and probably as nervous as hell, but I'm really happy with the result. One super important final step before I put the final clear coat on is to get a really, really good photo of the artwork. So this is for my records, and I use a nice, good camera, and I get a shot that's as clear as possible from straight on. And I do it before the clear coat, so I don't have to worry about reflections or anything inconvenient like that. So I just gave it a bit of a wipe down with an anti-static cloth to make sure there was nothing caught on it, and I gave both sides about 2 or 3 coats of clear coat. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give me a thumbs up or a comment. If you've got any friends who are stuck in isolation at the moment, please share this with them and spread the love. Thank you.